What's up, my comic comrades? Today we break down the origin of the Justice League's first villain and the antagonist of James Gunn's Suicide Squad, Starro the Conqueror. Starro first appeared in Brave and the Bold issue 28 in 1960. He was created by Gardner Fox and Mike Sikowski. Like I just said, Starro the Conqueror was the first villain to fight the original Justice League of America, appearing in their first appearance, Brave and the Bold issue 28, in the story called Starro the Conqueror. Then editor Julia Swartz said, the title Starro the Conqueror was inspired by a Ray Cummings story, Toronto the Conqueror, which is a 1930s sci-fi novel. Now, like most comic book characters, Starro has an original origin and a modernized one. But since this is an episode dedicated to his origin, we're gonna break down both of them. In the Silver Age, when Starro the Conqueror was introduced, he was just a kaiju alien supervillain who intends to take over the universe. He comes from a race of aliens known as the Star Conquerors. Physically, Starro looks like a gigantic starfish which contains millions of similar small drones that latch onto a host to control its mind. Starro then depletes worlds from their natural resources, then uses face-hugging aliens to attach themselves to the planet's population, then subjugate their will, usually while Starro the Conqueror is thousands of miles away. Starro is such a threat, even members of the JLA, including Superman himself, have fallen victim to his dominance, and they were barely able to prevent him from leaving Earth barren and lifeless. Essentially, his ability to dominate an entire civilization with ease makes him extremely dangerous. Which makes sense, that's why his appearance on Earth caused several of DC's heroes banding together as the Justice League to defeat him. Now that's essentially Starro's original origin or background, very straightforward but pretty cool. But you know comics, as time goes on, they have to change things for a modern audience. Enter the origin we got in Rebels Annual 1, Starro the Conqueror. In the modern origin, the being known as Starro the Conqueror was once a boy named Kobe who lived in peace on the planet Hattori. The people on said planet lived very simple lives and were considered very underdeveloped by other planet standards. Except for one thing they did each day. When all of their inhabitants congregated in a species-wide telepathic link and opened up to one another, which in turn made their society the pinnacle of ethics and cultural stability. But you know comic books, things don't stay nice forever. And that all changed when a gigantic alien starfish started hovering over their planet and sent its drones down to enslave the people. The people were put to work immediately, like mindless insect drones, grabbing their tools and marching. The nest would be dug, food gathered, and so on. This was always the pattern Starro used, but on Hattori, it was different, for these drones could not be rendered completely mindless. Though their bodies belonged to Starro, the link still existed. With that mental realm, the people were drowning in panic, rage, and fear, just wanting to be set free. One day, Kobe's brother Andres was somehow able to fight off the main control long enough to attempt to kill the queen of the Starro. As she was old, dying, and vulnerable, she had chosen this planet because it looked peaceful, underdeveloped, and non-threatening. So her final act was to spawn a litter of mother stars from which would rise the new Starro queen. The newborns would hatch and fight until only one survived. The victor would consume the last of the planet and leave that world to seek fresh victims. But again, Andres changed all of that as he fought off the psychic link long enough to try to bring down his axe, killing the new hatchling queen. But the queen was able to use Kobe, Andres's younger brother, to attack him and stop him from killing the queen, ultimately cutting his own brother's head off. But Kobe, being forced to kill his brother by the mind control, made him snap, at which point he tore off the face-hugging starfish drone, ripping his flesh while staring at the queen saying, "You shouldn't have come to Hattori." The newly born queen then tried to attack Kobe, but it didn't work. She instead became attached to Kobe's chest, and Kobe controlled her, subsequently destroying the remaining hatchlings and declaring that every Star Conqueror would be his. The Starro Queen even tells us in the comic that somehow he could control Starros because perhaps his union with me enabled it. The Starros were his to command. The Queen goes on to say, through us, he enslaved every intelligent life form we encountered. But unlike us, he did not work them to death, for every new mind slave increased his power. The strength of millions, then billions infused his body, and he swelled like a giant, his flesh intertwined with mine. His old name is forgotten like his old philosophies, cast aside like the drivel they were. He became Starro the Conqueror, drawn to the strong in war, incorporating their tactics, weapons, and soldiers. And the more he conquered, the more he knew that one day the entire universe would be his. And that is the modern origin of Starro the Conqueror. Essentially, a boy named Kobe from an alien race would take control of the Starro and become Starro the Conqueror. But now that you know Starro's origin, it's time to look at his powers and abilities. As you all assumed, Starro's main power is his mind control. It's so powerful, in fact, he was able to control several galaxies using it. He is outright one of the most powerful mind controllers in all of the DC universe. So essentially, Starro is one of the most powerful mind controllers in the universe. He could fly and is gigantic, which makes him extremely powerful and destructive, and also invulnerable to most attacks. As for Starro reading recommendations, check out Brave and the Bold issue 28, Justice League Europe issues 24 through 28, Rebels Annual 1, and Justice League 3000 issues 1 through 4. That should be more than enough to get you all started. And that's gonna bring today's episode of Variant to a close, but if you enjoyed today's episode, be sure to check out this one to my left. And if you like all of our content, be sure to subscribe, like, and comment. It always helps the channel grow. But other than that, I'll see you guys next time when I talk about all things comics.